this is the sum and substance of the verdict. Needless to say, this is a victory for India. How did India win this case? The short answer is India was on the side of the truth. But of course, in a court of law, you need more than that. You have to have a strong case, and this case has to be backed by strong arguments. So what did India argue in the International Court of Justice? India's first contention was this: Pakistan's military court sentenced Jadhav on the basis of a forced confession. Harish Salve, the man you just heard speak, argued that the Vienna Convention cannot be selectively used. And this is an important argument. We are talking about Article 36, 1C of the Vienna Convention. It guarantees India a right to give consular access to Kulbhushan Jadhav. Pakistan violated that right. India has always said that said this, and now the International Court has agreed to what India has been saying. Besides, the first principle of natural justice is to listen to the other side. That is the very basic. And Pakistan violated that principle. In fact, it is the biggest violation that Pakistan has committed in this case. Jadhav was denied a fair trial. He was wrongly arrested, and India was informed about it a full 22 days after the arrest. What explains that? This is criminal, this delay. Yet another breach of international law. Now to the question of who Jadhav is. India maintains that Kulbhushan Jadhav is a former Navy officer who was doing business in Iran. Pakistan fabricated charges of espionage and terrorism against him. Pakistan also alleged that Kulbhushan Jadhav was a spy and an agent of RNAW. The ICJ faced this question: who is Kulbhushan Jadhav? And the question was, will the court prioritize individual freedom over state rivalries? Or will it leave espionage out of the Vienna Treaty? Thankfully, the court decided that Jadhav had the rights enshrined in international law, irrespective of who he was. The court upheld India's argument that Pakistan did not follow due process. In fact, Pakistan violated another law here, the ICCPR. This is the International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights. This treaty ensures a fair hearing by an impartial tribune. Pakistan violated it. India's argument was efficient, well-directed, and broad-based. India basically asked the ICJ to scrap the decision of the military court and to force Pakistan to release Kulbhushan Jadhav. That hasn't happened. But India also went with a plan B. India said that if Jadhav is not to be released, then he should be given a fair trial with guaranteed consular access. And that has been accepted. And that was also the winning strategy for India. This ability to wade through various options, it gave India's argument credence. Now that Jadhav is guaranteed a fair trial, India gets an option to take the legal route to bust Pakistan's lies about this former naval officer. Settling disputes through a free and fair trial is the absolute minimum that India needed, and it got what it wanted. Now to the question of Pakistan. What can Pakistan do? The writing is on the wall. It should follow the order, both in letter and spirit. That would prove that Pakistan still respects the rule of law, at least to a certain extent. If Pakistan refuses to abide by the order, India will raise it at the United Nations Security Council.